Welcome to yoga. All right, let's get started. We're going to start seated. I've got a little bit of a different angle now, so you're a little higher, so hopefully you can see my whole body when I'm standing. This is our fourth class of a 5-week winter session. And those of you who've been joining on the YouTube channel, good for you, good for you. Always welcome to join me live Wednesdays at 4:30. I'm always here. And I always love to have real live human energy. So you're welcome. Please join me. Otherwise, keep using the recordings and send me feedback anytime. All right, so let's actually start with our left hand on our heart and our right hand on our low belly. We'll just do some grounding exercises to kind of bring us to our practice and bring all of our day into our body right now, right here. So go ahead and close your eyes or soften your gaze and just notice your regular breathing pattern. And just kind of notice the micro movements of your body. There may be little pulses or twitches, and there may be sort of a soft rhythmic billowing of the lower belly. Maybe a little bit of movement in the ribcage and chest. And just kind of say to yourself, hello. Hello, you. Hello, body. Hello, breath. And as you say hello to your body and your breath, send a greeting wash of light from the tip of your head down your ears and face and neck and shoulders. A nice affirmation, affirming hello to your shoulders, your chest, your back. Like you're just saying a huge hello, starting from the top of your body down, like paint pouring down. Hello to your chest, to your spine, to your belly, to your hips, to your back, to your pelvis, to your sits bones, your thighs, your knees, your calves, your shins, your ankles, your toes. Hello, 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 hello. We are here. Let's take a nice deep breath in. Four counts through the nose. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath. 6 count, exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. 2 more of those. 4 count inhale and 6 count exhale. And on that last exhale, let the arms fall to your sides. Take a nice deep inhale, sweeping the arms up. Take a look up between your hands. And let's just stay here for a minute. Let's see if we can really root the sits bones into the mat. Drop the scapulas down the back. Lengthen the arms up. Lengthen the chin up. Feel that beautiful length you have. Exhale, let's just bring the palms forward towards the ground in front of us and just release the head down, the chin to chest, and breathe. Big, luscious inhales and big, dense exhales. Slowly bend the elbows. With each exhale, and walk the fingers forward so you can just exhale into the stretch. Surrender into the stretch. Lift the belly button towards the spine. Engage the core. And keeping your chin down, walk your hands over to the left, sort of on either side of your left knee. And pull that right hip back as you drop the nose of the forehead towards the left knee. Breathe here. Heavy head. And on the next exhale, walk the hands over to the right, keeping the chin towards the chest. Now kind of anchor that left hip down towards the mat and reach the fingertips away as you drop the forehead and nose down towards the right knee. And on the next exhale, walk the hands forward and then walk them up. Place the fingertips, the hands behind the pelvis, fingertips pointing forward. Drop the lower leg onto the mat. Inhale, squeeze the shoulders together behind you and the chin to the chest. And on the exhale, press the pelvis off the floor. It might not get very far. And if you want, you can let the head back. And release. Bend those legs. Take them out. Give them a little massage. While you're doing that massage, you can kind of just sway your torso a little bit, right and left. And then recross the legs with the other leg in front. Sitting nice and tall, inhale, lift the arms up. Again, find the length through the waistline. Root the sits bones, lengthen the arms, look up. Keep the rib cage kind of wrapped. So you're not releasing the lower back or the rib cage forward. Exhale, just let those palms come down to the floor and have a heavy head here. Big sigh. Do whatever feels good here. If you want to just kind of rock back and forth a little bit, gently sway. Maybe you want to just turn your head left to right, or a little bit of a yes, up and down. Maybe a little tilts with one shoulder kind of pressing up and then the other. Whatever feels good here. And let's walk the hands over to the right, rooting and anchoring the left pelvis, the left side of the pelvis down. Lifting the belly button toward the spine. Finding that delicious strength along the side body, down the lower back. Breathe deeply. On the next exhale, walk the hands over to the left side. Anchor the right hip. Release the forehead down. On the exhale, walk the hands forward and back up to seated. Hands come behind the pelvis, drop the lower leg onto the mat. You may have to sort of separate the knees a little bit. Inhale, squeeze the shoulders behind you, chin to chest, and then exhale, lift the pelvis off the floor and release the head back. And pelvis comes back to the floor. Cross those legs, give it a little rub down. Maybe use the fist of the right hand to kind of get in to that leg a little bit on the inner thigh. Maybe get the thumb into the pelvis there. Pound the booty. Gently, let's just pat up the body, up the body. And let's just take a few minutes here to just kind of wake up the face. Take your fingers across the bridge of your nose, along the sinus, sort of the bridge right there underneath the eye socket, all the way back. Give yourself a little sinus self-massage. And then when you get to the ear, rub in front and behind the ear, like you have scissor fingers, and you're just kind of giving in front and behind the ear a little rub down. And then when you're ready, take those scissor fingers and actually draw them down along the jaw and then back and then down again and then back. And then take those scissor fingers to the space between your eyebrows, go above the eyebrows and down to the temples. Rub the temples one more time, above the eyebrows, down to the temples. And then just take all the fingers and just kind of give yourself a little bit of a sort of, what is this? Just a little flick along the edge of your face, all the way down and then down your neck. And then a little flick across your chest. And maybe a little pat on the chest, wake yourself up. And then take the fingers to the top of the head and just gently tap the top of your head with your fingertips. Yeah, stimulating the blood flow, the touch. Good, beautiful, all right. Let's take the right leg out and the left leg in. So my right leg is just shooting out here on the diagonal, not too far side. Take the left arm and sit nice and tall, reach up, maybe look up. Inhale, exhale, slide the right hand down the leg, grab the toe if you can, open up the chest, drop the scapula down the back, and then reach that left arm up and over towards your toes as if you were reaching your toes. Some people can actually touch their toes here. And just gonna breathe here, looking underneath that armpit. Try to keep rotating open with the chest. Yes. And then as you do that, pull yourself down with that right arm. Use that right arm to help gently stretch you over. Oh, feels amazing. If it hurts your neck, you can look down. There's no reason why you have to look up. We just want to try to keep the chest open, but you can do that while still looking down. Take a next inhale here. On the exhale, release that left arm down to the left side of the leg and the right arm down to the right side of the leg. Breathe here. And walk those hands up. Switcheroo. Left leg out, right leg tucked. Inhale, reach the right arm up. Exhale, slide the left hand along the leg. Grab hold of those toes. Open up the chest. Drop the right scapula down the back. Look under that armpit and then see how far you can get. Gently, since we're just starting class, into this stretch. Breathe. Take a nice deep inhale, and then on the exhale, rotate the right side body down towards the floor. Take the left hand to the outside of the leg and drape your torso over that leg. Heavy head. And walk those hands up. And let's come around onto all fours. Get into table. Hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Inhale, let's arch, look up. And exhale, round, look down. Getting the spine activated here. Pressing the palms into the mat, especially the root of the palms. Scooping the belly button towards the spine and really stretching between the two scapulas. That upper back. Elongate the breath. See if you can really match the inhale with the arch and the exhale with the rounded back. Good. Let's take the hips back, coming into prayer. And before we settle in prayer, let's take the hips to the right and then down through up dog and then left and into prayer a couple more times. So this is actually a great wrist stretch as well. And we're getting those arms powered up a little bit, and we're just getting the hip pelvis mobility going. Three times to the right and then three times to the left. Inhale as you move through up dog, exhale as you move through prayer. And rest in neutral. Take that right leg and extend it out. Lift that right leg. Flex the foot. And take the left arm off the ground. And just kind of notice how in this pose, automatically your core lights up. You cannot do this without engaging that core. So you want to imagine that your core muscles, your abdominal muscles, are holding your back like on a silver platter. And the arms and the legs that are extended are like the fancy stuff on top of the silver platter. And release. Extend the left leg. Flex the left foot, really stomp the back wall with the heel, and then lift the right arm off the floor. Breathe. And release, good. Go ahead and step. Actually, let's take the right leg out and then swing the knee through and see if you can step that right foot forward in between your hands. Press the pelvis forward. And then bring your hand to your knee, your right hand to your knee, and your left arm up. First, just kind of settle yourself here. And then when you're ready, just give yourself a little tilt to the right. Your torso comes over to the right. Open up that left side of your back, of your torso, and look to the left. You should feel a stretch all along the left side of your body, down the front of that, of the pelvis. Good. Go ahead and take the hand down to the floor, the left hand. Extend the foot underneath yourself and then shift the weight so that it's on your right leg is shooting out and toes are forward. Your hands are on the floor in front of you. And we're just going to go back, sending the booty to the heel, and then come up, and then go back again. So we're getting a nice inner thigh stretch, but we're also adding some mobility to the pelvis and the hip joint. Up and down. Up and down. Next time you find yourself up, take your left hand out to the left. Shift your weight onto that hand and extend the right leg off the mat. Bring the right arm up. Hold here for a minute. And then, I'm kind of adjust myself. Take the right arm up and over, creating a nice long line from your fingertips along the side of the body to the heel. Give me three crunches here, elbow to knee. One, inhale, two, inhale, three, inhale. To take the hands down to the floor, hands are down in front of you. Pick the right leg up, all the way around and back. Bring yourself back to the mat and then bring that knee to the floor and come into child's pose or prayer pose. Just kind of rock here for a minute. If at any time any of this feels uncomfortable in a bad way, make sure you modify anything that we do to fit your needs and your body where it is today. Let's try the other side. Go ahead and lift the left leg up, bring the knee to the nose, and then see if you can step that foot forward between the hands. Take the left hand to the left thigh, right arm comes up, find your stability here. And then when you're ready, just give yourself a little tilt to the left. Open up the chest and look under that armpit. Hand comes down to the mat. Kickstand your foot behind you. Shift your torso over to the right. And hands come forward. Left foot is out to the side, toes pointing forward. We bring the booty back to the heel, and then we come up and back down. And up. Next time you find yourself up, swing that right hand over to the right. Take the left leg off the ground and take the left arm up. Find that. Now press your pelvis forward slightly. You don't want to have your booty hanging out. Get your booty over that right leg. And then when you're ready, take that arm up and over, hitting the wall here. And we do our three crunches. One, two, three. And we swing that leg back as we walk our hands around to the front of our mat. Lift that leg and bring it down. Coming into prayer or child's pose. Awesome. Coming back into all fours. Let's tuck the toes, maybe take the hands slightly in front of the shoulders and take yourself into down dog. And let's just have a moment here in down dog where you get to do what you need to do, what you want to do, what your body tells you to do, whatever that is. Let's take that right leg up in the air and bend the knee. Let's circle that knee, tracing a nice big circle to the right three times. And then circle that knee to the left three times. Ooh. Yes, getting the heat going. Switch legs, left leg comes up, bend knee. Three times to the left. Three times to the right. Good. Now rock. Let's actually rock our body forward into plank. Now if plank, full plank doesn't feel good, drop onto your knees. Hold here for a minute. And on the exhale, elbows nice and close to the rib cage. Let's bring our torso down to the mat. Go ahead and lay your belly down on the mat. Pulling the mat towards you with your palm of your hand, lift the head, the neck, and the chest forward into a low cobra. Good. You know what? Let's just stay here for a minute. Take the hands down by the sides of the body. We're going to inhale here, forehead on the floor. On the exhale, we're going to reach the fingertips towards the toes. Lift the upper belly off the upper chest, off the floor as we lift the legs off the floor. Hold here like Superwoman flying through the air. And then release, forehead to the floor. I literally saw a 3-month-old baby doing this the other day, and he made it look so easy. So let's tap into our 3-month-old selves. Inhale, on the exhale, lift the legs off the floor, lift the upper body off the floor, reach the fingertips towards the toes. Breathe. Good. Exhale. If it feels better to lay your cheek on the mat, do that. Maybe rock and roll a little with the pelvis here. We're going to do that one more time. Inhale, big deep breath. Exhale, fingertips reach toward the toes. Wonder Woman flies through the sky. 3-month-old baby flies through the sky. the power of the three-month-old baby right here and release and rock side to side. Good. Let's bring the hands up above, resting our forehead on the floor. Take the knees apart so they're at the edge of your mat and click the heels together so you're kind of got frog legs. Inhale. On the exhale, lift the legs off the floor. So the knees come off the floor, the thighs come off the floor. And then we're gonna take a nice inhale, but we're just gonna tap the legs down on the floor and then exhale right back up. Inhale, lower the legs, exhale right back up. Let's keep going. Two more. On this last one, stay up and let's open and close the legs. Open, flick the heels. Open, there's no place like home. Open, there's no place like home. Two more. Flick, extend, flick, and lower. Woo! Good job. Roll over onto your left side. Good. You can rest your head on your arm or you can hold your head in your hand, whatever feels comfortable. We're gonna extend the top leg and I have a slight bend to my lower leg. Excuse me. We're gonna rotate the leg so that the toes are pointing up as much as they can. We're going to go draw the toe up the bottom leg, bringing the knee as close as we can to the side of the chest, extend the leg, and then lengthen it down with the heel flexed. Drag the toe up the leg, extend and flex the heel, and then release the leg down. Three more times. Bend, lengthen, extend, bend, lengthen, extend, bend, lengthen, reverse five times, extend, bend, lengthen, extend, bend, lengthen, extend, bend. I don't know what number this is. I think this is four. And last one. Good. Go ahead and place that top leg in front of the bottom. And we're gonna do a little inner thigh lift with that left leg, 10 of them. 10, and you can use your Ujjayi breathing. Good. So with the Ujjayi breathing, you close the back of the throat and you get a little hissing sound. I'm gonna flip over you so I can stay facing you, but you can just roll over to your other side. We've got, now we're on our right side of our body. Our left leg is extended. Bottom leg is slightly bent in front of us. Point the toe and drag it up the bottom leg. Extend the leg and then flex, really pushing that heel forward as you release. In, up, down. I'm using my top hand on the mat to stabilize. You really want your left hip right on top of the right. You don't want to be falling back. Stack the hips right on top of each other. I think that's three. And I think we did five. In one direction. One, five, and the other. Extend, bend, lengthen. Good, bring that top leg in front of the bottom leg, and we'll do 10 little pulses with fire breath. Here we go. Good. Woo. All right. Coming up to either a cross-legged position, or I'm going to get on my knees here. I'm using my blocks just to give me a little bit of height. We're going to do our 20 breaths, pranayama, life force breath. Inhale, reach and look up. Exhale, bring the arms through heart center 20 times in your own rhythm. And I invite you to play with your rhythm. Sometimes I go slow, sometimes I go fast, sometimes I start fast and end slow. Play with your breath every time we do this. It's a new day. It's a new way. Whenever you're ready, begin. Three more. Last one, interlace the fingers and send the palms to the ceiling. Walk the shoulders up the ladder one at a time. Right, left, right, left, right, left. And extend those arms down as you keep that length in the spine. Let's just take the shoulders around a couple times here. Other way. Good. And let's just take the head to the right and extend the left palm down, opening up the left side of the neck, rolling that shoulder down and back, lift the belly button towards the spine, engage the core. Sigh if you want to. And gently switch sides. All right. Find yourself a way to get out of your seated position. Come around onto all fours, tuck those toes, and let's get back into down dog. Three breaths here. Wrap those shoulders away and down. Reach the heels towards the mat. They don't have to touch. And lift the pelvis towards the ceiling. Press the palm, the bottom of the hands into the mat. We're going to inhale and lift that right leg up. On the exhale, swing and step it through. Go ahead and stay right there with that back heel. Lift it off the mat and come into crescent pose. See if you can lift the chest towards where the ceiling meets the wall. Find that crescent shape. Good. Go ahead and let that back heel fall to the mat and open up the hips into warrior two. Right hip should be right in front of left hip. Find your warrior two, wrap those thighs away, spiral staircase legs. On the next inhale, reverse warrior, lift the right arm up and the left one comes down to your thigh. Sink a little lower into that lunge. Keep that leg bent. Take the right arm to the thigh. Look over your left shoulder and swing the left arm up and over into side angle. Look down towards the mat. Take the left hand to the mat and lift the back heel off the mat. Bring the back foot to the outer edge of your mat. Grab your blocks if you need them. Put them on either side of the right foot. Lengthen the right leg. Don't lock it. Inhale, pull the top of the head away from the pelvis. Exhale. Layer the torso down over that front leg and just hang out here for a minute. You can stay here, or if you want, you can bring the torso up slightly, open up the body and do a twisted triangle. Right arm is open, right foot is forward. Hand comes to the mat. Bend the front foot, front leg, step back into down dog, and let's just do a little flow through here. Come into plank, lower through chaturanga, full chaturanga or half chaturanga with the knees on the floor. Press back up and into down dog. You can always skip that and just hang out in down dog. Lift the left leg, swing it through. Bring the hands, arms straight up. Leave that back heel off the floor. Come into crescent with the left leg forward. Drop the back heel. I made that more fancy than it needed to be. And then come into warrior two. With the left leg forward, come down into that lunge. Three luscious breaths. Inhale, reverse warrior. Take that left arm up and over. Right arm rests on the thigh. Sink a little lower into your lunge. Wrap those thighs away from each other like corkscrews. Keep that knee bent. Bring the left elbow to the thigh. Swing the right arm up and over. Side angle. Look down towards the mat. Take the right hand down. Lift the back heel and jump it to the edge of your mat. Straighten the front leg. Inhale. Lengthen the top of the head away from the torso, from the pelvis, and then drape the torso up over the front leg. stay here, or you can pull that left hip back slightly, lift the torso, and then open up the left side. Of course, since my left shoulder is not, I actually have a frozen shoulder on the left side, so I'm really working with limited mobility, but you can lift that left arm all the way open. Mine goes about here. You gotta work with what you've got. And hand comes to the mat. Go ahead and bend that knee and then step back, downward dog. And then if you want, do your little flow through your vinyasa or just stay in down dog. And when you're done, go ahead and bring your knees to the floor. Actually, let's just tuck the toes behind us and sit back on our heels. Stretch those toes out, get vertical for a minute. And go ahead and get some water. I think I forgot to get water today. Okay. Wow, time flies when you're having fun. Let's do some abs. Let's come on down to our back. Ooh, hug the knees to our chest for a minute. Give yourself a little rock back and forth. Maybe circle the knees out and in. That's good. And then in and out. All right. Feet flat on the ground. We're going to take the hands. Let's take the hands to the head. Actually, left hand to the head, right hand down on the floor. We're going to do a little double whammy here. We're going to inhale. On the exhale, we're going to bring the left shoulder to the right knee and then extend both the arm and the leg. And then we're going to tap the straight leg with the straight arm. And then, you know what? Let's just do the right side. We'll do 5 sets on the right and then we'll switch to the left. So here we go. Inhale. Exhale, shoulder to elbow. Inhale, extend the arm and the leg. Exhale, tap the toes and release. Inhale, exhale, shoulder to elbow. Extend. Exhale, tap the toe. Extend. Inhale, exhale, shoulder to elbow. Extend. Exhale, tap. Extend, exhale, shoulder to elbow, extend, tap, last set, shoulder to elbow, I've been saying. That's funny, shoulder to knee, elbow to knee, Lord have mercy. You guys know what I was talking about, hopefully. Do as I say, not as I do. No, do as I do, not as I say. Oh, gosh. Okay, try the other side. Let's see if I can get it right. Right hand to head. Inhale. Exhale. Elbow to knee. Extend. Fingertips to toes. Extend down. Elbow to knee. Extend down. Toes to fingers. And release. This is 3. This is 4. This is 5. All right, we only did 10. That's all right. It's enough. Let those knees fall right and left. Let's take the right knee into the chest and the left leg extend. And we're just gonna hug that right knee to the chest. And let's inhale here. On the exhale, bring your upper body off the floor to the bra line. So you're hugging your knee to your forehead. Inhale, exhale, switch. Inhale, switch, exhale, switch. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Two more sets. Good. Release, hug the knees to the chest. All right, let's just do a little rock and roll here, a couple of times, massaging our spine on the mat. Feels good, kind of playful, roly-poly. And then when we find ourselves seated, stay there, we're going to slightly lean back. So we're not right over our pelvis. We're on a diagonal. Our arms are in front of us, reaching forward. All we're going to do is open and close. Open and close. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. If you want an extra challenge, feet off the ground. Good. Ah, soles of the feet together. Little butterfly moment here. Maybe forehead to toes, whatever feels good. Okay. Finish off with our bridge. Come on down to your backs, hands down by your pelvis. We're just gonna do a very simple bridge to kind of quiet our minds and quiet our breath here. All we're gonna do is inhale, arms and pelvis comes off the floor. And exhale, everything comes down. We're gonna do 10 of these. Close your eyes and just fall into the rhythm. Matching the inhale with the rise of the arms and the pelvis and the exhale with the lowering. Last time you find yourself up in bridge, leave the pelvis up, but bring the arms down. press the palms into the floor. See if you can get the pelvis a little higher. Hold here and breathe. We're gonna take 10 opening and closing of the legs. Open, kiss the knees, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back to neutral. Slowly bring the pelvis back down to the ground. And hug those knees one more time. Good. Go ahead and grab the outside of the feet or the big toe, whatever feels good. Come into happy baby. That feels pretty intense. Let out a couple sighs here. Go ahead and extend the legs down on the ground and the arms above the head. Take a nice deep breath in, straighten everything, and contract everything. See how long you can hold your complete body in complete contraction. Every part, your face, your ears, your neck, your core. Hold it until it starts to shake, and then release. Remove the tongue from the roof of the mouth, stick it out. Swallow, say, ah. And then find yourself into corpse pose, deep relaxation. And we will seal our class, honoring the work that we've done. Find a nice song for us to listen to.
Strange, yeah. put your hands into your hands. And then smiles cover your heart. Baby, I'm to you. Strange.
Welcome to stay in Shavasana for as long as you want. Otherwise, you can slowly and easily find a way to sitting, and we will close our practice today with gratitude for each other, for the practice of yoga, for beautiful music, for challenging poses, for our imperfectly perfect bodies, our senses of humor that help us get through all of life's challenges. The spirit in me salutes the spirit in you. Namaste. Thanks again for coming. See you next time. Bye.